Good evening, everybody. So glad that you guys are able to join us for the Westlake Band Spring Concert. Thank you to those of you joining us live here at the Westlake Performing Arts Center, as well as those joining us on our live stream. Before we kick things off, I just want to take a moment to introduce our first conductor this evening, our student teacher, Mr. Bryant Anderson. Mr. Anderson comes to us from the University of Texas at Austin. Welcome. He is a saxophone player, and he has done so much for us over the course of this semester in Ames ISD. He has been teaching with the Hill Country Middle School Cougars, all 6th, 7th, 8th grade students. He has also been assisting here at the jazz bands. He has been leading big ensemble rehearsals with this group and has also been assisting with our other groups. And we have just been so lucky to have him to join us, to help us so much. I know that these students have learned so much from him, and we are just really lucky that we were able to be here for his last stop in his education. So please welcome Mr. Bryant Anderson. Before we play our final tune, I just want to have a moment just to say how proud I am of these students. This has been my first year teaching here at Westlake High School, and I have just been, I feel so honored to have such a wonderful group of students in such a crazy year like this. I'm so proud of their hard work, their resilience this year. Can we just give a round of applause for the students on stage? It has been an absolute joy making music with them, and I look forward It really hasn't felt like coming into work. It's been coming in to have fun with these wonderful students. Our last piece is entitled John Williams Movie Adventures. It's going to feature music from multiple Star Wars films, Jurassic Park, as well as E.T. We hope you enjoy John Williams Movie Adventures.
Thank you. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for joining us today. Welcome to those of you that are here in person and those of you that are streaming from the live stream. This group in front of you is the Symphonic Winds here at Westlake High School. We've got a really exciting program for you tonight. We're going to play two pieces. This first piece is called Wind Sprints by Richard Saucedo, and it is just packed full of excitement and technique, and it's been such a challenge and so fun for these musicians to put this together. We started working on this right after our last concert, our last UIL concert. So we've had a few weeks on this, and we've really enjoyed working on it. And it's an exciting way to start our portion of the concert tonight. So I hope you enjoy Wind Sprints. Logistically for these kids. You know, we have the at-home students that drive up every day to be a part of the ensemble, but then we also have the in-person students that wait like 30 minutes like after school. And so there's always just this kind of waiting time before eighth period starts where it's like, wow, these kids just have given up so much to be a part of this. So can we give these students on stage a round of applause for their willingness to make it work? And students, let's now give your parents a round of applause for really making it work for us. Thank you, parents. Okay, we have a tradition here at Westlake High School, one of my favorite traditions, which is as a senior student, if you make the All-State Band, then you are invited to perform a concerto on the end of the year concert with one of the concert ensembles. This year we're really lucky to be able to work with one of our students here with this band. We have student senior Andrew Guerra, who plays bass clarinet. Yeah, give it up for Andrew. Worked really hard this year to earn a spot in the Texas TMEA All-State Ensemble, and it's just such a, he's such an extraordinary young gentleman who just works so hard and has such a great work ethic, and it's just been such a joy to see him grow into a wonderful young musician, and then now to hear him play just so beautifully as just an expert on his instrument. So we are really, really excited to play with Andrew tonight. Please welcome to the stage Mr. Andrew Guerra.
Thank you.
If you are not staying for the wind ensemble portion, you're free to go. I want to remind you all that these students still have a responsibility tonight. We're doing our uniform turn-in, so they'll take just a couple of minutes to do that before they're free to go. And then if you're sticking around for the wind ensemble portion of the concert and for the senior portion, then you may stay seated, I believe. So thank you guys again very much for joining us tonight.
Thank you so much for joining us this evening, either in person or at home. I hope that you were able to enjoy the earlier portion of our performance. We had to have that little break in between as a nod to our COVID protocols. And I really hope that you enjoy the celebration tonight in Tulsa. We have some great surprises for you this evening, and I think some great music that you will have your toes tapping and you'll be singing as you're going out the door. This has been a rather tough year, actually tough 15 months for us since all this started, and it's looking now that we're all able to kind of see the end of the tunnel, right? And it's not the light coming from a freight train in our direction. It's a good thing, and we're looking forward to being able to move ahead with things. And that kind of makes it all that more important of what we're able to celebrate tonight. It's unusual, believe me, here in the Central Austin area for us to be able to do something of this magnitude and be able to do a live performance with people coming in. It's not happening at that many schools around here in Austin. So we're both grateful and feel privileged that we're able to do that, but also, you know, this is what we do. We create music together and we share it together. So this night, I think, will be a special night for us. We'd like to start this evening featuring one of our fine musicians. She is one of the drum majors of the band. She's an all-state player for 2 years, I think. And she's in the trumpet section as well. Going to be playing, and first she came forward with this piece. She said, "This is what I want to play." And I was like, no, because it was written for brass band. So they had like little E-flat trumpets in there, they had Herald trumpets in there, they had alto horns, which would be tough to find in the United States. All sorts of things, and I'm going, I'm not sure. And fortunately, we did a little more research and we found a band arrangement of it, so it's like, okay, we can play this. So please help me welcome to the stage Miss Jenna May playing concert piece. Just making sure that this is turned off during the performance by the bells. Thank you. Thank you. great. I don't know what your favorite musical is, but mine is West Side Story. So we had to cancel our performance at the Round Top Music Festival, and it's like all of a sudden we're going, well, we got a whole other week of preparation, so I thought, well, let's play this piece. And actually the same day, Ms. Robertson was showing us the trailer for the remake of West Side Story that's going to come out in December. So I thought, okay, the stars are aligned, we've got to do that. So I'm curious to how many of you have seen either at the movies or the musical live West Side Story. Can I see a show of hands? And, oh, great, that's great. You did much better than the people on the stage. In fact, I promised them that after this concert, we'd take a little time and I'd show them some of that from the musical so that they know what they're doing in here. So see how many of you can count of the different songs. This is West Side Story by Leonard Bernstein. It's an old, old arrangement by De Tort. Last year was our 50th anniversary, I think it was last year, of Westlake High School. And actually the year before, I think, was the 50th anniversary, but nobody really knows. So it was supposed to be last year, and we got all excited in the band program, and we wanted to commission a piece to commemorate Westlake High School's 50. So we're all set to do it, and it's supposed to be premiered at the end of last year, okay? Well, something else happened, and we weren't able to do that performance. So we're calling this year the 50th anniversary, although I think by now we're probably up to the 52nd anniversary. But who's counting? So in order to do this, I wanted to make sure that we got a person to write the piece for us that was very, very highly respected in the field across the country, in hopes that this music would be played across the country in both some of the better high school bands, but also at the collegiate level as well. So I searched through my Rolodex, and I thought, well, I'm going to go back to this professor from Michigan, named Professor Paul Dooley, and he, not Cooley like our assistant principal, Professor Dooley, actually we played one of his pieces the last time the Wind Ensemble played at Midwest in Chicago, Point Blank, and it was very challenging for us, but I knew that he had a reputation that would carry us through, and also he knew how to pull this off, because we were looking for a celebratory type piece. So, fortunately, when things started to come together this year, and it's like, okay, we can do this, I called Professor Dooley up, and I said, hey, we're thinking about performing this on an end of the year concert. Can you come and visit with the kids and be there for the performance? And he said, well, actually, I can. I can fit you in between things. So we're fortunate tonight to have Professor Dooley with us. He's going to tell us a little bit about the piece, and then we're going to play it for you, and you're going to stand up and applaud and love it. I promise, though, you will. It's a lot of fun. So, Professor Dooley, please come on up to the stage, and let's hear him.
So my music is generally very challenging, a little bit avant-garde, as was the piece that the band played back in Chicago. And I decided to do something a little bit different for this piece. And in order to celebrate the 50th anniversary of the high school, I thought maybe I'll try to run a march. But it couldn't just be any other march. I wanted to tweak some things. So I decided to make it really fast. Most marches are like 120. And I sped up the tempo much faster, almost like a circus march. And then I changed the time signature to be in 3/4, so it has this 3 feel, almost like a waltz feel to it. And I took a deep dive on a lot of the Sousa marches, studied them, and you know, those pieces are painfully simple and powerful, and I really wanted to try to do something along those lines. So without knowing that Stars and Stripes is a tradition here at the end of the at the end of each school year, there's some definite Stars and Stripes influence in this piece. So you can listen for some of the melodic contours and phrasing. I'm kind of tipping my hat to Sousa in that, all with the goal of celebrating this major event, the 50th anniversary of the high school. So the rule in composer world is you don't talk for longer than the length of your piece, so I'll stop right there. I hope you enjoy it.
One more funny thing. It doesn't have a title, really, or it's a working title. And he sent a working title, I think, Westlake Celebration, and that's what's on the piece. But it's like, okay, can we come up with another? So we did a survey with the students in this group. We sent a survey to the teachers, so they had some input as well. We had a wide range of suggestions. Some of them were very hilarious. and others were really appropriate, and we still haven't decided on a title for this piece, but for tonight it's called Westlake Celebration in commemoration of Westlake's 50th anniversary. Can we have the house lights on, please? House lights, there we go. Professor Dewey, thank you so much. I promise you if we play here again sometime and all across the country. So. We're going to take just a moment. We have some seniors that are joining us. This is normally when we do Stars and Stripes and we invite alumni up here. We can't do that this year. And we invite some parents up here as well, or family members. Can't do that either this year. We're already a little bit crowded on the stage. But we have, yeah, they're already coming back to us here. So this is a tradition that started, I don't know how many years ago, but it was in existence before I even came here, which means long, long time ago. Probably closer to the zero or first year celebration than where we are now, certainly. So this is Stars and Stripes Forever. We hope that you really enjoyed the concert tonight. Yes, you may be able to pick up some similarities from Professor Dewey's tip of his hat, as he said, to John Philip Sousa. In John Philip Sousa's Stars and Stripes Forever. Oh, by the way, on the screens, we have some of our students. We can bring them up as well. They only remember we do a big occasion at the very end. So instead of marching down the aisles and joining us for the very end, they're gonna join us on video for us, okay? So again, thanks for coming tonight. Before I go, there's several people I need to really thank. This all can't be done, and I've been to a number of performances here, especially in the last month or so here. The theater is staffed magnificently with both teachers and students, so please help me thank and show our gratitude for the tech. You've seen most of the band staff up here, so we won't thank them. Of course, some of our middle school people cannot be here, but thank the middle school staffs from both Horst Ridge and Hill Country Middle School, and as well as our administrative teams at Westlake, Hill Country, and West Ridge. So they've been extremely important for us getting through this whole year. We're very appreciative of that. But the group I think I really want to thank the most are you parents that are here in the audience tonight. We would not have been able to make it through this year as easily, I guess that's the word, as we did, without not just your support, but your positive attitude and going, yes, this can work, we can do this, and I want my child to participate. So I am eternally grateful. I shed a tear when we started our first concert band rehearsal, just by hearing those sounds that I hadn't heard in like 9 months. So it's really special. It's special to us on stage, and I know it's special to you. So thank you for sharing it, and thank you for your support. This is Stars and Stripes Forever.